All it needed was a storm like you'd never seen before. A flash flood and the Black Tar Gang. You've probably seen their picture in the papers. Three ordinary-looking blokes. Nothing to indicate the greatness they'd later achieve. But to those in the know, each of these fellas had special, some might even say heroic, qualities. Like, for instance, Lotto. Lotto was called Lotto because every week he bought a Lotto ticket, hoping he'd win a few million bucks. Lotto was the unluckiest man on the planet. God is cruel when he gives the unluckiest man on the planet control of a steam roller.
Oh.
Oh,
no! Lotto, come on, back it off, mate!
Oh, jingers, mate! Mate, you are a bloody menace!
What's it doing parked there in the first place?
The almighty one. Come second on. And our King Kai tells
us. Oftentimes when Lotto put money on a horse, it not only lost, it needed to be put down.
Oh, that'd be right.
Then there was Wookie. His real name was Glenn, but everyone called him Wookie because he reckoned that one day he saw one of them hairy things out of Star Wars in his backyard. He used to read them cheap, shitty magazines. The ones that reckon Lady Di is alive and well and married to an Eskimo in Iceland. Or that aliens abducted Ally McBeal and stapled her stomach. That's how come she's so thin. Then there was Sue.
Yeah, right, yeah.
Sue, whose real name was Bob, was the gourmet of the group. Whereas the others had settled for an ordinary meat pie, Sue would go for the steak and kidney, or the beef and bacon. Never again. What a finger was doing in a steak and kidney pie is one of God's great mysteries, especially since on that finger was a ring which got stuck in his tubing. Now, the ring itself was of no particular value, and despite all the coverage, the previous owner never came forward to claim it.
How did you feel?
But Sue used his brief celebrity well, sold the story to the gentleman of the press, got himself a cheap lawyer, and sued the pie company for $2 million.
Would you ever consider eating the meat pie again?
Oh, maybe. I think I'll try pasties for a while.
They settled out of court for $100,000.
You lift me up over threshold?
Which was just enough to buy himself a big house and a beautiful young bride. But not enough so he could quit his job like he was hoping. You see, there's some men born lazy. Some men become lazy, and others have laziness thrust upon them. We never quite knew which it was with Sue. We just knew he was lazy.
Hey, what's the story, mate? What's happened?
Oh, it looks like someone's just chucked a rock at me car.
What? Sue?
Whenever any of the gang had a grumble, the others would be there to help out. Like that time with Lotto Scratchy. Lotto, the unluckiest man on the planet, had finally hit the jackpot.
Yeah!
Now, Lotto wasn't going to let a flimsy grate get in the way of sudden yet much anticipated wealth. You see, the Black Tar Gang, faced with a situation, were resourceful men. Some might even say lateral thinkers.
Oh,
For 2 days, they dug up the street. For 2 days, an entire block went without water. For 2 days, the council thought there was a gas leak. Stop.
A gas leak?
Yeah, we're going to have to evacuate the whole street, actually.
How long's this going to be for?
Oh, until we find the gas leak.
In the end, though, they never did find the scratchy.